everybody. Am I audible, Ananda?
Yes, yes, you're audible and all the
Is my video clear? Is the microscope view clear, Ananda?
Yes, yes, it is.
So it's a wonderful to see you all on a virtual platform. So this man with an astigmatism of almost close to 1.75 diopters, and we're doing a toric here. So for all my residents, 1.12 side ports, because I love doing bimanual rather than a coaxial. And one great thing that I really love is this Phenocone Plus. I use in all my routine patients because this has made life really very easy for us. Keeps the anesthesia, maintains the dilatation, and specifically in all our femto cataracts, maintains the dilatation. So I'll be introducing you to new technologies here. I think we all have been using their Vivenex Toric Light Meditna, sir. And I believe the biggest advantage with this Vivenex Toric, excellent, please, is the rotational stability that this toric offers us. And the basic reason is their haptics. Their haptics are roughened both on the anterior and the posterior surface. And this roughening prevents the lens from getting any degree of rotation. So worldwide comparison, they stand almost less than 5% rotation and less than 5 degree of rotation as compared to competition. I think a circular capsulotomy that I have fashioned is essential. An open bag is clear cut no whenever you're doing a toric IOL. So Ananda, I have a system with me. This is called the Q Pro, powered by the iFlex. Can you show the machine here? And the Hoya guys have got this machine on a demo basis. And yeah, I'll be using this wonderful system. This is a Venturi system. I'll be using a sub 2 millimeter here. Light me dekhna. And not much experience that I have on this machine. So pardon me if my chamber stability goes away. And so I've done a hydro dissection. You could see the fluid wave passing. I push in viscoelastic. And this is the handpiece, the curved tip. And this handpiece is common for their both anterior and posterior segment, where you can do a phaco frag and anterior segment phaco surgery as well. So can somebody help with my powers, the settings? What are the settings? No. So 300 is the vacuum that I'm using on a Venturi system. 30 is the power. Light me dekhna bhai ji aapko. Light me dekhna. Bahut acha dekhna. Saline noise. So this is a Venturi system. 300 vacuum.
I remember I'd used this machine at Nagpur in 2019.
Okay, wonderful. So I do a straight chop here.
Lovely chop.
So I just request you to look at the cutting. See, it's amazing. I mean, very few cases that I have done, but the cutting that I have seen yesterday on, I did 4 or 5 cases, grade 4 cataract, and it was just moving as if I'm using a 6-crystal handpiece. The handpiece is still a 2-crystal, but it works wonders. The chamber stability was good, and the Venturi system made my life very easy. It's a very fast system. Even at 300 vacuum, I was a little very cautious because things were moving very fast.
What's the flow rate? If somebody can just...
Can somebody help me with the flow rate, please? Can somebody help me with the flow rate? Bhaji, koi dikkat to nahi hai aapko? मूव करके
चेंबर
सांस
लुक्स
लेता रहे,
एब्सोल्युटली रॉक
या
सॉलिड
एब्सोल्युटली स्टेबल,
या
सुमन पेशेंट को कंफर्टेबल करो, एयर में प्रॉब्लम आ रही है उनको ब्रीदिंग में. सो राइटली टॉक्ट बाय डॉक्टर वसावड़ा, आई ऑलवेज यूज मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम माई लेफ्ट हैंड rather than the right, where I am trying to manipulate in the interior chamber. If you see closely, a tip for the residents, that the right hand most of the times remains where it is, so that the wound is respected, and the left hand always guides the pieces into the phaco handpiece. So this is the stage where I would like to stop. I never make the chamber shallow, tight as much. And I would push viscoelastic before releasing the handpiece, and that too very specifically for all my posterior polar cataracts. So a quick word for the lens that we are using, it's the Vivinex toric, and as we all know, Vivinex is an aspheric lens, it's a glistening free lens, and the beauty of this lens is that it can tolerate. Am I on the IR mode now? So the beauty of this lens is that it can tolerate decentration for almost 0.75. So we all know that these aspheric lenses, once placed in the bag, have certain degree of decentration, and this decentration would then ultimately lead to induction of the chromatic effect. The images get a little oblong or longer. Now the reason why this lens is sparing is the central 2.4 millimeter optic, which has the innermost circle of 1.2, which has a positive coma. So if you see here, why I say bimanual is this reason, because the sub-incisional part is very easily approachable, whereas in a coaxial, it's difficult at times to manipulate. So in a single go, you can, you know, be able to clear off the entire cortical matter. So I usually polish all my lenses, capsules here, sorry, and now the light mein dekhna hai, light mein dekhna hai. So this is the sandblasted system that I use. This has an irrigation on the up, and very gently I hug the posterior capsule. Saline, please. Start.
What would be the size of your excels, Dr. Sahu?
So it's close to 5. So, as I was talking, and I'll show you. So this is the Vivinex toric. If you see here, it's 23.5 with 3 diopters of cylinder, and you have those steps marked on this. The beauty is the step 1, step 2, and step 3. So now let me closely describe what it is. Step 1, through this nozzle goes the viscoelastic. So if you see here, the viscoelastic advances up till the nozzle here. So the step 2 would be removal of this system. And step 3, the most important, and mark me, whenever you have your OP assistants loading for you, we should always instruct them, once you push this, see what is happening is, once I'm pushing this in front, the trailing haptic is getting folded over the optic. Just closely, Anava, is it clear to you? To the panelist and to the video here? See. So once I'm pushing, the trailing haptic is getting loaded onto the optic. So just see. And it's moving forward. Now once this is done, you do not never push it back. Because the moment you push it back, then there are chances that the trailing haptic might get crushed. So this is a quick learning tip that by mistakes we all have learned. And the third and the final is removing this from the box. And I'm a great fan of this wonderful delivery system. See, this is a screw driving system, and I push it slowly, and it beautifully the system advances. Sonai.
Yeah, Sono, it's one of the finest lenses even I used, and I'm also a big fan of this lens. It goes through a very small incision.
Yeah, so that is what I'm showing you. I have a sub 2 millimeter wound here, and just see very finally, I have the left hand moving across and very gently. This goes directly inside the bag. Now that's the beauty of this system. So the staff is smart. They have already put in the two marks. This is the 0180 and this is the mark of the placement, which is 12 degrees here. 170, 168 you said, right? So what is the axis of placement, please? 12 degrees. Okay. So let me have the marker. This is their mark the reverse way. Is 178. Look in the light mein dekhna sir, light mein dekhna. As Dr. Tatyal has already explained nicely that the viscoelastic has always to be washed in around the lens and the bag has not to be distended. I think that's a very important teaching pearl that sir gave us today, because most of the rotations which occur is within the first 1 hour of the surgery. So I always take these patients back on the slit lamp after an hour of the surgery, just check for the location, and then we send the patient back. And the bag has to be completely devoid of the viscoelastic and it has never to be distended. And specifically in high myope patients, I always tap the lens so that it gets snugly onto the posterior surface. The posterior surface gets snug on the capsule. So this number one is the rotational stability that I found is very amazing. Their toricity is on the posterior surface. Their asphericity is on the anterior surface. The marks that you see here can be seen beautifully on the slit lamp, gives us a good location that we can do.
Are you removing the viscoelastic from behind?
Yeah, I was removing the viscoelastic and now I will go in the bag. As you see here, I am underneath the IOL. You see the waves coming off. Am I centered or not? Is it clear?
Yes, yes.
Yes,
so the placement has to be.
Why you are not doing hydroimplantation?
Sorry, Gaurav, I am not able to hear you.
I said, in my toric IOLs, I like to do hydroimplantation for this reason, because you know the case is over as soon as you implant the lens.
Yeah, so Gaurav, the only reason is why I don't do with these screw kind of injectors. I think with the multi-cert that they are shortly launching on this Vivinex platform, I think that will be a great boon for surgeons like you and me who can do a hydroimplantation and you know do away with these complications of late rotations.
Sonu,
yes, the multi-cert injector is actually very good. I've using it with the Linux and the Vivinex.
Marker, you know?
And they are excellent injectors, new injectors.
Dr. Sonu,
yes, sir.
IOC has also come out with an injector that is going without the viscoelastic, only by the fluid. So that there's something new that can be applied in toric lesion, all type of injectors in future.
Sir, I'm not able to.
In case of toric IOLs, I think.
What I'm saying that
yes,
IOC has come out with injectors. That
yes.
does not require the viscoelastic.
Oh, wonderful.
So that's a very good thing for especially for toric IF, all the companies.
Okay.
Come out with the same injectors.
Okay. Sir, actually, I have not been with that experience. So I'm not using my Callisto here for the sake of the public who doesn't have, because most of us are devoid of this system. So if you see here, a Mendes is almost equivalent and gives you an accurate positioning. And most of these times, I hardly use my Mendes because it's all in the mind that you can actually position the IOL. My resident has wrongly put in here. This is the continuous bunker. This is the 180 mark here, and this is 178. So instead of 12, they did it 178. So I'm trying to position at 12, and so this would closely be to 12 Mendes.
I think another advantage of this lens is the active oxygen treatment on the surface.
Yeah, so
increases lens, the
Yeah, very rightly said, Anaga. Their posterior surface is treated with active oxygen radicals. So the basic concept is, so the polymers and monomers, they have a strong binding with the posterior capsule. So that is one reason which prevents the lens epithelial cell migration, and that prevents the PCO formation. The fourth is they have a 360 degree square edge. Now this square edge would again prevent the PCO formation. And if you could see, the lens is there in the bag, the chamber is formed, and the bag is not distended. I have tapped, I've cleared all viscoelastic, and we'll send the patient, make him sit for 1 hour in the OPD, and then recheck on the slit lamp the exact positioning. So thank you very much for this patient listening on this first session of the Vivinex Toric. And this Vivinex Toric is available from T1 to T9 model. And their spherical equivalent is between 10 to almost 30 diopters. And the cylinder can be corrected from almost 0.75 to 4.5 on the corneal plane.